Hi everyone, Piet Kalemeijn here. I hope you're having an awesome day. So in today's video I would like to show you what thermal considerations are on a PCB and how you can make sure that a component that has to be separated from heat on your PCB but still has to be on the PCB, how it can function well. So something like this, you might have seen it before, a PCB with a gap. Question is, why is that gap there? Of course, I gave it away already, it's because of thermal considerations. This is a temperature sensor that should be far away from everything as it generates heat to make sure that there is an accurate measurement. But what are the most important things for thermal considerations? How would you approach your design? I have made a video about it, let's dive into it. Thermal considerations, this is an important one as well. I think it's a good idea to use thermal reliefs to make soldering easy and more evenly distributed. So on the top side over here, what you see here is the thermal reliefs on a via. So this is more schematic. You could choose not to use them and then the via is like this. The problem is, if you want to solder this pin, so if this is a pin, for a true hole component and this is completely attached all the way around to a copper plane, you will need to put a lot of heat on there to really be able to melt the soldering tin. So the issue there is that your component could become too warm and already be destroyed during the soldering process. Also, if you need to do some fixing by hand, some soldering by hand, if there is no thermal reliefs and it's a very small pin but connected to a ground plane that is quite large, you'll have a very hard time soldering it and not breaking your component. So that's why, in fact, you should always use thermal reliefs, and it's typically set as a standard in these manufacturing programs. So what you see happening over there with these vias, I told you it's not a full circuit, it seems like it is split. Well, that's exactly the thermal reliefs that you see over here of that point going to the ground plane. That's that. Components generating heat, try to isolate them from the other components, but prevent hotspots from occurring in your PCB. So if you have a lot of components on your PCB, let's get an overview over here, and maybe we could assume that the radio module is generating a lot of heat, all the other components not. In that case, you have a hotspot on your PCB. You can avoid that by placing heat sinks or making sure that there is some ventilation over that component. But it is important that the components around it are not affected by it. Especially if you're doing temperature measurements. So for instance, we have our BME680 over here. If this is very close to a component that is heated up by being active, then your measurements of course will be off as well. So to do that, there is some tricks to avoid this. So temperature measurements, you could make a thermal decoupling from the other circuitry. And this is something that I took from the BME680 datasheet. It's not the datasheet, but the handling, soldering, and mounting instructions. This is a datasheet that we have not seen yet, but it's an interesting one. It gives you instructions on how to solder the component, some warnings, precautions, and then design guidelines. So this is mechanically how you want the air to flow and how you don't want it to flow to make a good measurement. To avoid cavities, these kind of things. And then this is exactly about these hotspots. So if there is a hot component over here, you would place it on the other side. That's the best place to go. If you have thick traces, the heat will travel through these traces all the way to the BME680. So you need to avoid having big traces because it will transfer the heat. So if you have maybe a big ground plane going to your temperature sensor, that is not a good idea. Then same thing over here, if the BME is close to your hot component, of course, yeah, it will heat up. What you can do is, these are some options, is use trenches around the BME680 so that you are really isolating this part. I'll show you that in a minute. You could use thin interconnections for the ground or flexible PCBs so that it is completely isolated. So an interesting way is to put this somewhere on the side where it will not be heated too much, and then try to isolate it with some traces. So very quickly, you would do this more nicely, but I'm going to draw it very quickly how you could do that. So I'll use a thick line for that. Let's see if we can make it. Let's go with 2 millimeters. So over here, it's on the side. I still have some options here to go out with my routing. So let's say that we do something like this. So that's a mechanical layer. This is something that you will not see in 3D design. But what I'm going to do is select this and create a cutout, a board cutout. So we go Tools, Convert, Create Board Cutout from these primitives. Yes, let's see if that works. And if we then have a look in our 3D design, you see that there is an actual slot over here. So if there is some stuff or some heat traveling all the way over here, this will already be blocked. What we still have below is this ground plane. So you could also put a keep-out layer over here so that you don't have that ground plane underneath, because the ground plane, if that gets warmer, this one will of course still measure that. So you could place a keep-out layer over there so that that component is nicely thermally isolated. So that's a way on how to do that, and you're able to route your signals around the slit. It's just supply and ground, and then your I2C signals. So that's an option of doing that. Then thin interconnects, this is for the ground interconnect, so rather than connecting it to a thick wire for supply or ground, you use some smaller interconnects to again have this thermal decoupling. Flexible PCBs, that's of course the best way to go, but an expensive way to go. So I hope this video was interesting for you. I hope you learned a bit more about thermal considerations on a PCB. If you have any questions, of course, as always, feel free to put them below in the comments. If you liked the video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. And if you like the channel, of course, you can always subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.